Good day, ladies and gentlemen. This is Minister Edward J. Robin here today on the fourth day of November 2021. There are a rising number of people that are coming to knowledge and awareness, prompted and motivated by the threat of having their freedom sequestered and literally taken away. So because of the nature of freedom, and that all through history, men and women have had to stand in order to defend it, well, it tells us there's always a motivation on the part of certain groups of people to take that freedom away. And that's always been a record of our existence here on Earth. So when one discovers that there's certain scriptural positions relative to freedom that one can apply successfully, most assuredly, this is a wise course if one has faith. And I say if because not every man or woman has faith. So this offer of having your freedom respected and to gain the knowledge of other men and women, you're gaining their knowledge of what you know now, you're going to share it with them. Is laid out in the scriptures, so making it pretty easy for people to understand that all of this complicated confusion in the world, the various information that the media wants to feed us, trying to find out, well, who's feeding the media? Is there a financial relationship between the news that comes out and the media itself? So there's some pretty interesting discoveries one can come up to conclude when you do a little bit of research, for instance, about who's running the media and are they connected to who's running the med farm industry. Well, as it turns out, they are. So this is pretty powerful information that one can utilize to gain private agreements to establish your freedom by those private agreements. Now, I've done many videos on the private agreements, but it seems to be a bit of a stumbling point for a lot of people in the beginning, and they're not quite familiar with the power and message of pointing to Christ as your director at Matthew 5:25. So when one decides to point to Christ as your director, your Lord and Savior, and bring him up something a bit different than what you get in Sunday school or at church on Sunday morning. When you're telling whoever it is, could be the mayor, could be the premier, could be your president if it's the United States. When you're bringing them into awareness that you've recently discovered that you're not a person and you have accepted Christ's offer at John 15 and 16. Well, that immediately brings an obligation when you accept John 15 and 16 as an offer. And that obligation is to spend a good portion of your time diligently making sure of your election to the people that might be running the system, like I said, your premier, your health office. Whoever it is that they may have some assumptions about you, and I guarantee they assume you're a person. So once you discover via the scriptures, Deuteronomy 1:17, 10:17, 2 Samuel 14 and 14, Matthew 22:16, Acts 10:34, Romans 2:11 and James 2 and 9. And there are more, but those ones they come flowing out easily. And the James 2 and 9 says, if you respect persons, you commit sin and shall be convinced of the law as a transgressor. So once you make that point available, that awareness and that knowledge that you've taken up the biblical offer of not being a person here, there's no authority that exists on the planet to intimidate you to participate in personage. So it's a two-word approach here. One, you recognize your ministry of John 15, 16, and then you have a duty and an obligation to let everybody know that may assume that you're a person that you're not, and that you can only follow God's law from this point on. And it's like you're getting a contract, or the obligation is upon you as the watchman to warn them not to assume that you're a person anymore. It's very offensive to your faith, and you're giving them fair warning via this agreement. So the agreement could be in any topic that you pick. Most people know what their facts are for their particular situation, whether it's their children, their marriage, their mortgage on their home, or their dog catcher. Whatever that you have a problem with, the scriptural advice is to get an agreement and do it quickly before they drag you into court and you're there before the black-robed judge. So this is really, really simple knowledge. It's very childlike, and Christ said that we would have to be as little children to get to the kingdom of heaven. And so this is how it's done, by letting them know that you've accepted Christ's offer. You're now his ordained minister, and you can no longer correspond to the world of persons, and you're asking them to aid you and direct you so that you can deregister out of that system and get a evaluation of your life estate and what it's worth, so as to do an audit of that life estate to collect the annuities that have been collected since you were born. You see, every man and woman has a blind whole life policy put upon them when they're registered with the government. The government then uses the body as surety, the registration, it's deemed as a surety, to create that bond certificate worth, in Canada, $8 million. And they collect 12.3% per annum annuities on that. So the first year they've collected $1 million in annuities, and they set that aside into a trust account inside the Consolidated General Revenue Fund here in Canada. So that all exists in a reality, a real sense. It does exist that the bankers that own the corporation called Canada and all the other ones in the world, they hold title as the receivers to that corporation, and all the registrants inside that corporation are called constitutors. They signed up and by a simple agreement promised to pay the debt of another. So once you discover that you, by mistake, misled or deceived, signed up with a dead prostitute and became a constitutor to pay this debt, well, you can understand that a constitution is a set of rules for the constitutors. It only applies to the constitutors. It says right there in Section 32 of the Charter of Rights and Freedoms for Canada. So I didn't particularly take a lot of stock in that charter, because it's only speaking about persons. It does not deal with men or women in that charter, only persons. So when I came across the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, it gives men and women top billing. It gives the right of resurrection, which is self-determination, the number one thing on the page. So if you're not there demanding accommodation of these so-called people that assume that you're a dead person of law, if you're not demanding accommodation for your faith, well, it's quite simple. You're not going to get it. This particular law, the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, is not self-exercising. You must demand accommodation to get the benefit of its offer. And that's the only way that it comes to life. It sits dead and dormant until somebody's screaming they have a demand for accommodation. So you can get the agreement that they have an obligation and duty to accommodate you by writing them and saying, I'd like you to agree with me that you have an obligation and duty and are bound and obligated by the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights. If you have any evidence of this fact being wrong or incorrect, please get back to me within 20 days' time, or I'm going to confirm that we have an agreement with regards to this covenant being binding upon your office, and I'll have two witnesses confirm that you didn't dispute, and then we'll post a notice in the newspaper to take our private agreement into a community where people can see that we stand in honor and we agree, and everybody will know. So but when that's done, and believe me, it's been done, and it's very, very powerful, it works. There's no fooling around with getting an agreement when Christ said to do it. Then he's the master here. He's in charge. So I encourage everybody to start to work towards that. getting the private agreement with regards to your faith and beliefs so that you can't be held accountable and assumed as a person anymore. So thank you so much for taking the time to listen to this short video, and I hope that's helped focus in on the solution for the problem, demanding accommodation for your faith and beliefs, ensuring that you get it through to the target that could be a man or woman that's in charge, could be your governor general, lieutenant governor. There's many people to choose from that a minister of Christ has an obligation to educate. If they're assuming that you're a person now, you've got the obligation to educate them otherwise. So I hope that's helped you so you can figure out how to get that agreement with them. And if you need any help, you can find me on Telegram at Owlmon, O-W-L-M-O-N. So I thank you all again for listening, and may God bless. Bye for now.